Good morning, Hank. It's Thursday. Great video about Puerto Rico, but you don't need to hear that from me. You heard it from Ricky freaking... always pointing the wrong direction. It really is like Brotherhood 2.0 again. You heard it from Ricky Martin. Right, so listen, Hank. When the Yeti and I lived in New York, we did not own cars because you don't need to. But then in 2007, we moved to Indianapolis and we started to have to drive cars like regular Americans, and I inherited Mom and Dad's old car because apparently I'm a 17-year-old. And ever since, I have been driving Mom and Dad's old car very happily. It's a great car. The windows don't roll down, which is a little bit of a problem for drive-through situations, but otherwise excellent. But Hank, that whole time, as you know, I have had a dream. Hank, you need ambition in this life to push you forward, but sometimes that ambition can drive you mad. Look, for instance, at Captain Ahab and his white whale, Gatsby and his Daisy Buchanan, Kim Kardashian and her burning desire to have a sham wedding. Hank, in January of 2007, one of your first Vlogbrothers videos was made from the Detroit Auto Show, an auto show that is famous because it marked the emergence of the Chevy Volt. It was a beautiful concept car that then became a beautiful vehicle in production. And I waited. I waited, Hank, because I knew that chasing your dreams can destroy you, and also because I didn't have the money. I waited, Hank, for 6 long years until yesterday. It's my Chevy Volt! So Hank, the Chevy Volt is an electric car. You just plug this end into your wall and this thing into your car. Runs on electricity for about 40 miles and then switches to a gasoline-powered generator. However, I rarely drive more than 40 miles in a day, so I should be good to maybe never buy gas again. Is an example of an exaggeration. What can I do? I'm excited!
You know how you start this car, Hank? You push the power button.
What? I can listen to my Pandora radio. As you can see up there on the left, it uses telepathy to know how many people are in the car. There's this little green ball that tells me when I'm being naughty. I was just naughty. Oh, seatbelt. Oh, it's just like nerd fighters. Always telling me to put my seatbelt on, even when I'm in a cul-de-sac. Now, Hank, the Chevy Volt is perhaps the most politicized car of our time. Lots of people are like, why would you buy that when a Toyota Corolla is so much cheaper?
You must think you're gonna fix global warming, right?
Buying a new car is not a carbon-neutral enterprise, no matter which one you buy. I didn't buy a Chevy Volt to try to end global warming. I bought a Chevy Volt because it's awesome, it's super fast, and you can put a car seat in the back. That said, call me crazy, but I would rather power my car from my electricity, which comes from the wind blowing a few miles away, than from oil. But Hank, so far, in the first 12 hours of my Chevy Volt ownership, the best thing about it is that I know you are very, very jealous. You want a Chevy Volt as much as I do, but you can't pull the trigger because you're the cheapest person in the world and have never bought a vehicle over $500. But I actually admire that about you, Hank, and that's why when you come visit me in Indianapolis, you can absolutely ride in my Chevy Volt. You can't drive it, you can't sit shotgun because that's where the Yeti sits, but you can sit in one of the back seats. Hank, I see, oh, I forgot the Pizza John collection. For the next 72 hours or so, these 6 variations on Valerie 2776's original Pizza John shirt design will be available for pre-order at dfdba.com. Hank, these variations were made by you so that you could make another of my dreams come true, my mustachioed face becoming a clothing line. They're only available for this one pre-order period and then they will disappear forever. They're like the Buddhist sand paintings of Pizza John shirts. Hank, I will see you tomorrow.